The interesting thing is that a society has programs, some more successful than the other, how you learn a language, how you learn to write, how you learn to use your brain to think mathematically or symbolically, and how you then use your eyes and how you train the larynx to make sounds so that the muscle waves have a particular sequence, how you learn to pay attention. So we all have these rituals about how we're going to function as an adult starting in childhood. And we are trained in those behaviors. And we are judged by how we take on these societal patterns of relating. But nowhere is the same sort of attention paid to people who reach an age where the changes in their body shape have already taken place and they don't know how to behave to reorganize how they're to behave. We think that as you get older, well, you should keep up certain faculties, take brain tests or brain exercises or go to the gym. But this is really different than a voluntary effort about how you exercise in the gym, how you're using yourself, how you are training yourself, educating yourself to have a different body.
What you talked about, all the expectations and how society has defined how you use yourself at certain ages, that there is not that kind of narrative for older age. And the whole narrative is about loss and
it's under 200 years old, maybe 100, maybe, I would say just a generalization, about 150 years, where the demographics of how many people are living past a certain age has grown really gigantic, and has for a lot of reasons. But there's no program. This is an age that has emerged in a number of people in which it calls for how does one form their aging rather than how does one adapt to their aging? How do they make a shape of their changed body structure rather than trying to use it in an old way which ends up hurting them or results in injuries like falling? So this is an educational dynamic which is now emerging big time, especially within the last, I would say, 25 to 40, 50 years.
And this is how the societal structures could be formed, because they're not formed yet.
That's right. So you even go on to say that there are no roles, or very few roles, for a person who's acquiring years. So, for example, when I got to be 75, I said, I've arrived. I've arrived at another age shape. I could recognize something is changing me. And I began to think about how I'm paying attention at work, how I use myself, how I get up out of the chair, what contact means, how much contact, what is the arc of how much excitement I can take, how much I gesture, what kind of expectations and responses that I need. So I've arrived at a place where my body is recognizably different than it was 10 years ago. And how am I going to shape this? And I gave myself a decade. I said, it was an arbitrary figure. I just said 10 years, okay, I'm 70 and I'm heading for 80. How do I want to live through this year as I encounter a different pattern of thinking, remembering, engaging, working, what are the changing values, changes of experience, and how does things satisfy me? What is it like to change how I eat, when I eat, how I... So this now I realize is the challenge of acquiring years in which there is really no program. What do they mean about retiring? And how do you then use yourself to make a contribution.